5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Heyo, everybody. Welcome back to the Drunken Nerds podcast. My name's Dan. Over here on the other side is Schubert.
Heyo.
Schubert, back in action. What's going on?
Back another week.
We're back for another week. We're excited, ready to go. Schubert, where are you? That's the biggest question, because every week you're somewhere different.
Big shocker here. I'm back in Orlando, hanging out by Disney, Universal. Same old, same old.
Smart man. The big question is, have you been to a bar recently?
That's a stupid question. I just came from dinner. I went to Old Red's at Icon Place. It's Blake Shelton's bar. I know you don't like country music. I love it. So I had a great time for dinner. Last night, of course, I went back to our favorite spot, D-Rex.
I think the question that we all need to know, were there souvenir cups?
Two for two. Two nights in a row.
Two for two. Oh, excellent.
So we're drinking one over here. There we are. Yep.
Old Red.
T-Rex one is sitting around here somewhere. It's not like I don't have seven or eight of them lying around.
The souvenir cups are incredible. You understand, like, why don't all bars do it?
I'm beginning to think I have a problem.
Yeah, you definitely do.
But, you know, it kind of makes sense. Like, tonight it was, I think, $15 for the first, which was including the cup, and then like $6 for a refill, which for tourist prices, that's not that bad. $21 for two beers.
Right. And you take home the cup.
Take home the cup.
It's great because basically you're giving them money for the souvenir cup, and they're paying for their cups that come in every month, whatever. They shatter. They get messed up all the time. So you're paying for like the refills. It's a genius business idea.
I think tomorrow I might go on a hunt, see if I can go find any places I haven't been to yet.
There's apps for everything. Is there not an app for souvenir cups?
Kind of like George Costanza's toilet app, but for souvenir cups. Am I onto something here?
I might be onto something. You're in the best spot for souvenir cups because they're
like, oh, it's everywhere, like, all you look. Everywhere you look. It's just a matter of finding the ones with the best deals. Tomorrow, Friday, might be a thing.
I'm jealous. So you're going to Universal soon.
This weekend, I got a whole trip planned. I kind of splurged, went for the hotel on property, got fast passes 2 days in a row. They got long hours. I think it's like 9 a.m. or not. I think it might be earlier with the hotel. I think it might be 7 a.m. until 10 p.m. So that's about 15 hours in the park each day. I'm going to try to do it. We'll see what happens.
I expect a lot of souvenir cups from City Walk. I want you to do the bar crawl and get as many souvenir cups as you can over there.
I'm going to see what happens Saturday. I'm going to try to push myself at the park. And by the time I get out of the park, I might be in rough shape. And even if I collect some souvenir cups, there's a good chance I forget them at a stop. So,
well, you might need to rent the stroller.
Yeah, the stroller worked out last weekend.
So you might need to rent
2 weekends ago, whatever the hell it was. Yeah. But I think by myself might get into some trouble if somebody sees me with an empty stroller.
You've already pushed the boundaries a little bit. So
they're gonna call a missing persons report. Amber alert.
You don't want the Amber alert.
No. I got one the other day, scared the hell out of me. I was like, yeah. Jesus, what the hell is that?
It's a funny thing you said that, because there was an Amber alert when we were at Disney 2 weeks ago. I didn't bring this up. We were eating at Bell's Castle for dinner, and there's no lie. The Amber alert went off. Katrina got it. My wife,
like the whole restaurant.
The whole restaurant had beeping everywhere. Like, oh my goodness, it's an Amber alert. And yeah, it was in Florida.
That's what happened. Similar story. And I literally thought the Chinese were coming for us. I thought I was ready to hop under a desk and take cover.
So, well, it's good to know you're still in Florida, Schubert. Are you ever leaving, or are you going to stay in Orlando forever?
We'll see. It's looking like I'll be down here for at least another week, maybe more. Okay. It's nice down here. It was 92 yesterday, so I don't know if coming home nice anytime soon in the cards.
I feel like we should have a segment just where in the world is Schubert.
That would be pretty good.
But seems like Orlando seems to be the destination.
I try to hover around here as often as I can.
Smart man. All right, let's get started. So we got some. So we're gonna do clips in between our segments. This we're getting real technical here.
New features.
You know? New features. So here we go.
This week's hangover.
All right, so
are you hanging out at like Chippendales or something?
First of all, that was Bryan Cranston's voice for the voiceover, if you didn't pick that one up. Second of all, I had to put a we want to do this week's hangover for what happened this past week. So that's gonna be our next segment. And when I think of hangover, I thought of the movie.
Explain the picture to me though.
I'm getting there. So I'm thinking of the movie The Hangover, and when The Hangover, obviously in Vegas. So I'm going like, you know what? I got to find a picture in Vegas when we went to Vegas. And so I came across this photo, and I was like, you know what? We have to add this. So the people who aren't seeing this or listening, basically it's half-naked men sitting on a couch.
And this without, is when we – without context, it's a little jarring.
It's a little jarring. But this situates it perfectly because this is when we went to Vegas. You know, we were at the Aria, really, really nice suite over there. And I think this is our second night in at Vegas. I think we've been there two nights now. So we wake up in the morning and our friends are getting ready and they literally are so hungover that I don't think they could close half their body. Like they're just sitting there trying to drink the beers because you don't want to waste a day in Vegas. But it just reminded me of this week's hangover. It was miserable, but we fought through it, and it was an incredible weekend. So that explains the half-naked men that are hanging out over there.
Might become a staple of the podcast.
Might become a staple. It was very disturbing. I remember coming out of the bathroom and seeing the three of them just kind of like lounging. Like, what are you guys doing? Like, we're trying to get ready for the day. Where are the rest of your clothes? They didn't know.
Wearing jeans, t-shirtless, that's an interesting move. Not a move I'd make myself.
No.
Maybe shorts I could see or I don't know, anything other than jeans. I feel like t-shirt goes on before jeans.
Yeah. Yeah, they did everything backwards, which is acceptable because we're already two nights in. And yeah, once you go to Vegas, I feel like you're all in. Like you want to take a day off and sleep all day long. But you know, like Vegas is an all or nothing sport. Like you're either gonna die, or we're gonna keep going.
Yeah, you're gonna get through it.
You're gonna get through.
You'd have to be in pretty poor health to actually die, I think.
Yeah. So, anyway, that brings us to this week's hangover, talking about what's going on this week. Schubert, I know I want to bring this up to you. Obviously, we need to talk about the Pikachu that's sitting over your shoulder.
Yeah, I got a few Happy Meals today.
Yep. So I know you want to talk about McDonald's bringing something back. Why don't you let us know what you're excited about?
Yeah, well, I went for the Happy Meals. I stayed for the good news. The good news is that McDonald's, after a three-year absence, is bringing back the Orange Hi-C.
So that's big news for you.
Huge. I mean, it was really the only place you could get it. I mean, you could probably find it in the grocery aisle, but it was never the same. I know there's been fans everywhere clamoring for it for the last 3 years. They're finally bringing it back. Hopefully it's not like the McRib where it only shows up like once a month for every 10 months or whatever they do for the McRib. Hopefully it's permanent. But I was in there getting some Happy Meals today because they come with Pokemon cards. I had to get some, open some packs. And I heard the good news. I'll be back. I eat plenty of McDonald's as it is, so nothing really different. But.
Did the people in the drive-thru window look into your car, look for child seats or any sort of look for children?
So that kind of concerned me. I didn't want to order it through the drive-thru, so I did mobile order, got it delivered to the car.
That's a smart
idea. I didn't want to have to face anybody.
It's a scary idea. It's a smart idea.
I'm not alone, though. I've heard stories already of people going in and buying like just asking if they can purchase like 500 packs of the toy, which is the pack of cards. And they have been selling them to the people. So I know I've seen some people be upset about that because their kids aren't getting cards because some asshole went in and bought 500 packs for himself.
Well, if it they're wasn't paying for it and they're not serving the food, why not? So what kind of, I can ask this question. So you got two Happy Meals, right?
Correct, yeah.
What did you get?
For food?
Yes.
I got two hamburgers, two small fries, and two bottles of water.
But don't they have to give you a side of fruit or something?
No, you can, can't. You can switch that out.
So you got double fries. I do this all the time with my kids. So you have to get like a hamburger, nuggets, small fry, and then like apples or like
so that smoothie. that actually kind of confused me. One of the Happy Meals came with two things of fries. One only came with one. So I wasn't sure if I was shorted one or got an extra one.
I think you were shorted one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh.
So they probably figured I had enough. They probably figured I wasn't going to eat the food anyway, that I was just buying them for the guards when they got
Yeah, they probably figured it out. So, well, good for you. You get anything good? Any worthwhile cards in the pack?
I don't think there's any sort of extra rarity. I think it's kind of, they're all about the same, but we'll see. We'll see when the market develops a little bit. I just like opening packs at this juncture.
True.
I'm kind of a junkie.
All right. Well, you excited for High C?
Yeah, we're getting to High C. We got Pokemon. chances are I'll be at McDonald's quite a bit in the next couple weeks.
Is really doing you solid over there.
It's a good week for McDonald's.
Oh, man. All right. Well, that's good to know.
I got the box over here in the background. It's kind of fun. You can like punch out the ears, put them in place.
Oh, boy.
I'm a sick man.
I think Burger King had to catch up. If you were this excited for this, you need to get Burger King, Wendy's, or something to catch up here.
We'll see. If they had the McRib going at the same time, right, that would be like the trifecta of McDonald's specialties.
Yeah. Yeah. Stop. I'm a big fan of the McRib.
I was thinking, apparently, the McDonald's over on International Drive is like a secret special spot where you can get all kinds of weird crap. Like I think you can get like a McDonald's pizza or something over there.
Oh, wow.
Might have to pop my head in there sometime this week, see if they got anything good going on.
Yeah, you're right there. Might as well do the tour of the McDonald's when you're there too. Have you been to the McDonald's over at Disney, that Disney McDonald's?
I think that's the one I'm talking about. No.
That's not International Drive. That's actually inside of Disney.
Okay, no, that's different then.
Yeah. It's crazy. We drove by it every single time on the Disney bus. Went to the parks a couple weeks ago. I think it's huge.
Maybe I'm confusing the two, but either way, it's one of them.
Go check out the Disney one. I want to see what it's like in there. I kept wanting to, but I couldn't tell the bus to stop. So anyway, that's McDonald's thing for Schubert here. We'll move on from there.
Big story.
I had to bring it up first.
Maybe we'll have to try something out next week. I'll go get some of the High C. We'll add some vodka to it, see if we get a special.
Yeah, there you go. That makes a little more sense.
We might have something on our hands there.
Yeah, that makes more sense. All right. So, Schubert, another thing that you want to talk about.
McScrewdriver.
I like that. See, that's fine. And now we're talking. Now I think I could visit McDonald's with you if we go that route.
Yeah.
I'm in. So, all right. So we'll move on from the Pikachu food. And I know you had something to talk about with Spider-Man. So obviously Keanu Reeves is entering the Marvel Universe here.
Which it was only a matter of time.
I know he's teased it. So
he's teased everything. I think too, we always talk about The Rock as being franchise steroids. I think Keanu is pretty close to taking the mantle. It seems everything he does these days is just turns to gold. Mm-hmm. Only a matter of time he was added to the universe. Still unseen which universe he's really going to be in. It sounds like it might be closer to a Venom type universe rather than the actual MCU, whether it ties into a Spider-Man movie or not. But he's slated to play Kraven the Hunter. You familiar with that?
I am.
Awesome. Yeah. He's good fit for the role. He looks the part. He's maybe not as, I don't know, the look. It's close, but it's not exact. But he's going to make it work. You know, it's foolproof.
Yeah, they're bringing him into it. They're going to make a big deal about it. He's been incredible.
It's going to be a solo movie. I could see them doing the movie with like a CGI Spider-Man and not Like, you don't need an actor. You don't need Tom Holland to play Spider-Man.
Right.
So I could see that working. Otherwise, I don't really have an idea unless they're just doing like some sort of origin story and doing sort of like a substitute comic book character as Spider-Man.
Right.
Either way, though, I'm excited for it.
I'm ready for it, too. Keanu Reeves, you know, I was down on him for a while. And then all of a sudden, he just started blowing up. Like, why did
he's
I
in everything.
This guy? Yeah, exactly. He's in everything. Everything he does is great.
New Bill and Ted was fantastic. One of my favorite movies of the year.
Yep. It's a good one. So I know it's not a ton of news, but, you know, some small things that are going to pick up and obviously going to get bigger throughout the year.
Yeah, it's been a slow news cycle.
Yeah, haven't had much. That's why
we have casting, cancellations. Yeah. That's about it.
Yeah. So, but there's still some small things like this other thing, which we got to talk about. This is a little disturbing to me. So did you watch?
Usually when you bring up something disturbing, it's actually very disturbing.
Well, did you watch Raw this past Monday night?
I did, yeah.
Yeah. Did you see the Lana versus Nia Jax match?
I did. In real time, I know where you're going with this. And in real time, I actually missed it. It completely went over my head. I didn't hear about it until I hopped on Twitter. Go ahead. So I'll let you handle this one.
So we're not going to spend much time on wrestling at all today, but it was a Lana versus Nia Jax match. Nia Jax, if you're not familiar with her, is a very large woman. And they were wrestling, and all of a sudden she gets kicked out of the ring. She starts just screaming,
She fell right on her butt.
Right on her butt. And so she was just – I mean, I don't understand how that could be the first thing that you want to say, like if you land on something or hurt something. But it was just so, even Lana behind her was like looking, you could tell, like she's like, this is very strange to be screaming this. But
my instinct was that she was either doing it to try to get viral or get herself over or something of that nature. Like,
do you think they planned?
Not on WWE's part. I think it was her. Maybe doing it, or like she knew what that was an instinct.
Yeah, I had to rewind it to see, like, maybe if there was something like sticking out of the ring that she landed on the wrong way. Like, it was so confusing, but like, she's a big girl. I mean, I feel like a lot to hurt her, but
yeah, she's got some padding.
It was disturbing, very disturbing. But that was the biggest thing, is all over social media. I think every single person's been talking about this.
I was watching and I didn't even hear it. And then I hopped on social and I'm like, what did I miss?
It's a small thing in a women's match. A women's match that nobody would ever want to watch. And next thing you know, it's huge. So they're going to bring this up again, I believe. They have
I don't know. I think they're going to sweep it under the rug.
You think so? After how big it's gotten?
I think it's one of those that they, like, I hope they don't make it a thing.
I don't either.
If you know the WWE, if they can start printing T-shirts tomorrow, they're going to. Moving on.
We'll move on from that one. I had to bring it up because it's all over social media. It's a little too much. All right. So the Super Bowl, obviously, was a big thing this past weekend. That's probably the biggest news that we have. Forget about the game. Who cares about the game? So we'll talk about the commercials and the trailers first. So they had two big things. What was that?
And Tom getting drunk today.
Yeah, and Tom, we were going to get to that. Tom getting a little drunk, yeah.
Well, we'll start with the commercials.
We'll start with the commercials. We'll start with the two trailers first, then we'll get into commercials. So the two big ones, obviously, were Falcon and the Winter Soldier, which is awesome. I mean, it's going to be incredible.
Yeah, to me right now, it's can't miss. I don't see there being a way they screwed up.
Yeah, there's no way. They're going to make this – it's going to be great. I mean, that comes out at the end of March, too. It's pretty soon.
I think it's right after Wanda. I think Wanda starts, and then next Friday it's Winter Soldier. They might give us, like, 1 week off.
Yeah.
But either way,
you watched the whole trailer?
I did, yes.
Does Bucky always fall off of, like, moving vehicles on the side?
I think that's his thing.
It's his thing. I feel like that's his thing. Like he's on a truck on this one, I think. He just falls off the side hanging off. Like, there he goes again. So, but the trailer looks incredible. You can tell it's going to build up to a big thing. Wanda's been great. So
a lot, a lot of cool stuff in there. You get a first glimpse at U.S. Agent, which is kind of a Captain America filler type character from the comics. We got a first look at Baron Zemo's mask, which is pretty cool. They're going, he was in Civil War, obviously, but he wasn't really comic book accurate. We get the mask. It's pretty cool. It looks, it, you wouldn't think there'd be a way for them to make a purple hockey mask look cool, but they did. There doesn't seem to be any reasoning for it, so we'll see what they do there. It'll be pretty cool to see. And we get the return of Sharon Carter. We haven't seen her in a while, so interesting to have her back.
Yeah. So, great trailer. I was excited. This is the beginning of the game, too, so it got you all hyped up.
Yeah, right away, which is nice.
Right away. Yeah, the other big thing coming to Disney Plus was the movie, I think it's Raya and the Last Dragon, that's coming out in March. So Disney Plus has started cranking things out. They started off slow, but you can tell they're starting to crank things out.
Yeah, just quick on Raya. It looks okay. I'm not that excited, but the last couple Disney animated movies, the trailer hasn't really got me that excited, and I've loved every one of them. So it's probably no different.
Yeah, they're not going to miss. If they're putting something out, I feel like they're doing their vetting, and it's going to be good. So, I mean, I know there was another trailer, which – freaked me out because I think it was called
M. Night Shyamalan.
Yes, that one. What's it called? The old something?
That looks creepy as hell. I'll watch it.
Man, come on. That brought me down the mood watching that. M. Night Shyamalan.
So, honest to God, I don't think I've watched more than like a dozen movies in the last like 5 years that weren't Disney or like The Rock or huge blockbuster movies. M. Night Shyamalan, I'm in on it. I'm in on it.
You're in on that one?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I think it's cool.
Yeah, we'll see about that one. But
then we got Furious, I think, was the other big one.
Yeah, F9, what they called it, F9. So, yeah, they're going to keep going with those. I mean, those actually are pretty good. They're entertaining. So, I know nothing about cars. Do you?
Hobbs and Shaw is actually the only one I've ever seen.
Yeah. So. You haven't seen any of them?
Nope. Hobbs and Shaw's it.
They're entertaining. I would check them out if you just want, like I said, your popcorn movies.
I am. I'm a big blockbuster guy.
So. Yeah. So, yeah, there was two other movies that are nothing big. But for the commercial, Schubert, I got to ask you, what was your favorite commercial during the Super Bowl?
So that's easy for me. It was the Tide with Jason Alexander.
Yes. With the sweatshirt?
With the sweatshirt.
That was amazing.
With the theme song to The Greatest American Hero, which was actually George's answering machine in Seinfeld. So it was completely like, I don't know if they were, they had to have been going for it, but everyone I was with was like, huh? What do you mean?
Yeah.
I got it. So it was a kind of a little nice nod to the Seinfeld fanatics.
Anybody who watched Seinfeld better have known what was going on in that commercial.
That's what I thought, but I don't know.
How?
Well, it's not the exact, like, song.
Believe it or not, George isn't at home. Please leave a message at the beep.
We got Dan singing over
there. I must be out. All right, pick up the phone.
Who could I be?
Believe it or not, I'm not home. That's, like, identical when it comes to that commercial.
It is. So.
Yeah, so I'd be disappointed if somebody said they're a Seinfeld fan and couldn't pick up on that.
I also liked, and it just so happened that it was in the same block of commercials, was the Jimmy John's commercial with Brad Garrett.
Oh, yeah.
It was like a sitcom TV side characters bonanza.
Yeah.
I enjoyed that. That was my favorite.
They're both really good. Two of them that I really liked, I love the Samuel L. Jackson one, the Verizon commercial, which I thought was great. You know, it's just funny about lagging's not the way to lose. And the guy's like, but I lagged, so I couldn't win. He goes, that's not an excuse. And so it was great. The animation was incredible. And the other one was Shaggy, the Cheetos commercial.
You like the Shaggy?
Oh, that was great. That was fantastic.
He sounded a little off key to me. I don't know if that was he's getting older. I mean,
he hasn't done anything in a little while. So, but
it was good though.
Yeah. Other than that, you have any other notable commercials you liked?
Not off the top of my head, I liked. I already brought up, I'm a Blake Shelton fan, so I liked that one. But obviously, the Bud Light Legends was fantastic.
Yeah, they killed the night again.
I don't know if you saw, but after the game, they had the Real Men of Genius guy sing a song about the Buccaneers. That was pretty good.
Yeah. Real Men of Genius, man. I'm glad they brought it back.
I hope they bring it back for good. You know, everybody knows I'm a Bud Light man, so.
Yeah, it's true. I'm drinking Bud Light right now.
Of course I am. Yeah. Where is it over here? Yeah. I'm almost gone. You almost need a refill.
Yeah. So the commercials are pretty good. And the last thing I guess we'll talk about is the halftime show. Did you like that?
I loved it. My favorite, we'll call it contemporary halftime show. Prince was not as – that was after they did almost exclusively old-timers. But I think other than Prince, you know, Bruce, U2, it was easily my favorite one.
Yeah, it was entertaining. And he definitely – you know, just him by himself and his dancers. It was incredible. He didn't need any special guests, and it was fun to watch.
That was one thing I liked. I liked how there were no special guests.
Yeah.
The past couple of years, it's been all about, oh, who are they going to bring out, and who are they going to have?
Right.
I like how they made it about him. It was quick, to the point. It was kind of like a greatest hits set for him. I loved it.
Yeah, good. So, and I know the Super Bowl's a big thing, and I got to ask you this, though. Did you watch the Puppy Bowl?
I admit I did not.
You didn't?
I forgot about it.
You didn't watch Snoop Dogg at all?
I planned on it, but I forgot about it. I started playing PlayStation early in the morning and kind of had to get keyed into when the game itself was going to start. So I missed most of the pregame festivities.
All right. I know there's not a lot of nerd talk in the past, you know, 15 minutes we've had here, but you have to watch the Puppy Bowl. I feel like Snoop Dogg is the best commentator on earth. He's the best.
So I fell down the Big Show hole the other day, which is it's on TNT. It's with Bert Kreischer and Cody Rhodes is a judge and Snoop Dogg is a judge. Mm-hmm. I was bored with the show, but I was staying there just for Snoop Dogg's commentary.
Yeah, his commentary is unbelievable.
We got a preview of that a couple weeks ago. He was on AEW, and we were like, "Whoa, he's pretty good." Oh, it was the Mike Tyson fight.
Mike Tyson fight, yeah.
Yeah, the Mike Tyson fight where he was on commentary, and it was worth the price of the pay-per-view alone. Yeah. Then he was on AEW, then he was on the Big Show. Now, anything he's commentating, I would watch.
Right.
I'd watch him commentating a baking competition.
Yeah. Yeah. No, he basically did with Martha Stewart during the Puppy Bowl.
during the Puppy Bowl?
They were baking. Oh, yeah, they were baking.
Maybe I'm some sort of psychic over here.
Yeah, they were baking. So, wow. But hey, we missed out on that. But
yeah, maybe I'll have to pull back around. But Snoop Dogg, anything you see Snoop Dogg commentating on, watch. It's can't miss TV.
I agree. So, That's pretty much
who won the Puppy Bowl?
I can't tell you that because that's a question for later.
Oh, no.
So I don't want to spoil anything. I
backed myself into a corner right there.
You did. Knocking over the boxes over there. Don't ruin your perfect Happy Meal box.
Collector's item.
That's right. So that's pretty much all the card events for the past week. There wasn't a much. There's no video game news.
Yeah, it's been a slow week. No.
It's been a real slow week. But I have to bring this up since you've called me out the past 2 weeks about being sadistic and talking about people who die. So I might as well just keep it going. So without further ado.
We're gonna call this a segment of the week, I guess, huh?
Segment of the week. So let's see who our next victim was.
Oh, God.
So we lost another great Billy Brown from Alaskan Bush People.
One of my favorite shows.
Yeah, which is great. So I don't care. And people who call out, oh, it's tax fraud show and all this. It was a fun show to watch. Billy Brown was great. Unfortunately, I think he died from a seizure, actually.
Yeah, he's been in pretty bad health for the last couple seasons at least. So could have been a number of things, but sad.
He's pretty young, with 62, right?
Might have been higher 60s, but
yeah, but that's an unfortunate movie or TV show star who died.
He hasn't been on the show all that much the last couple of years. So I'm sure the show will continue with the Brown clan.
Yeah.
But
yeah, that was a tough one. I did watch that a lot too. It was a great show. A mindless show, fun to watch. That's the way to live.
You put anything on the Discovery Channel or History Channel, I'll watch it.
So. Yeah. Yeah. So
And I've considered going off the grid a couple of times. So kind of a inspiration.
Make your own little island, take some tips from them.
Yeah.
So but I hope I don't have to do this segment every week, but I have a feeling that it might
happen. You've been on a roll. So
who knows? Yikes. See what happens next week. You also see the founder of the Supremes died too today.
I did. I missed that one.
Yeah, my dad was devastated. She was only 72. I mean, I thought the Supremes, I figured she'd be in her 90s, but only in her 70s.
Also, Larry Flint died today.
Larry Flint died.
Yeah, so he was in his late 70s, but if you had seen a picture of him, you would have guessed he was easily 100. So,
yeah.
That was the biggest shock. Not him dying, the fact that he was only in his 70s. That was wild to me. But we should stop speaking illy of the dead.
Yeah, we can't do that. We'll show them respect. I mean, obviously, you know, we feel bad for the family. He had a big family. So
maybe not feeling too bad for Larry Flint.
Not too bad for Larry Flint. So Schubert, we have another segment here that you've come up with.
I came up with this, yeah.
You did. So let's put the screen on there.
Drunken asshole story of the week.
Jesus. All right, so we have the drunken asshole story of the week, and that's you, I think.
It looked like me in that video.
That was you. You were so we're going to bring up a story about, obviously there's drunken stories every single week, but one particular close to our hearts here, there was a man that was arrested. This is according to, where did we get this? NBC2. So a 70-year-old drunk man was arrested at Port Charlotte at the Chili's. Outside for passing out in the SUV. So the cops came. And so the 70-year-old
sounds like he got a little overserved at Chili's.
A little overserved at Chili's. So they try to wake him up out of his SUV. He directly punches a paramedic right in the face, knocks the paramedic right back. So
for 78-year-old, he must have had some power. He must have had some power.
Yeah, so we'll go through the story real quick and then figure out what actually happened at Chili's because it must have been quite the scene. So after
we all know I'm quite the Chili's connoisseur.
Yeah, so
at Matt Does Chili's on Instagram, you can see me. I've visited quite a few in my day.
An insane amount. It's scary the amount that you've been visited.
So the scary part about this story is I reviewed it. It happened, I think, last Thursday.
Yeah, it did.
I was driving by this Chili's at right about that time, considered stopping. I said, I'll save it. I'm going to go tomorrow's Friday. I'm going to go tomorrow, Friday night instead.
Yeah.
So I drove right past this Chili's right about that time.
You could have saw John.
I could have witnessed. I could have witnessed. It could have been fate.
You could have saw the whole thing unfold.
But something must have steered me away. I must not wanted a ruined Chili's experience.
So this man, after he punches the paramedic, the cops grab him. They throw him into the cop car.
Somehow, this guy's a badass for 78 years old.
This is what I don't understand, all right? He's in the back of the cop car. Somehow, he kicked through the plexiglass, hit the cop, gave him a concussion.
So he's given out two concussions.
This is the second concussion. This is the deputy now who's driving the car. Knocked him out. They had to pull the car over. Another cop came. So anyway, this guy, 70, you should see his mugshot. I mean, he looks like just he's happy in the mugshot. Very happy.
Well, he got two blows in before he got taken away.
I cannot believe the amount of destruction this guy did.
So this guy at 78 looks way better than Larry Flint at 78.
I would say he does. Yeah. The big question that remains here is, what can they really serve you at Chili's enough that get you to that point?
Well, I mean, neither one of us are 78 years old, so it's kind of hard to tell what kind of tolerance exists there. But I imagine
he's a big boy. He's a big boy. So you think, how many Presidente margaritas do you think he had to drink to get to this state?
So for me to get to that state, it would be at least 15.
Yeah. What about a 70-year-old veteran? I mean, this guy has obviously put his due in when it comes to drinking. He's probably got better tolerance than both of us.
Yeah, he's got some damn stories for sure.
Yeah. He had to put down like 20 of those things.
Yeah, so this might be on the Chili's. I don't want to make assumptions about Chili's, because we know I love Chili's. I don't want to make assumptions, but I think this guy probably got overserved. We might have a Pam Beasley situation over here.
Yeah.
He's probably banned for life. It's safe to say.
Yeah. I don't think Chili's is going to welcome him back.
I might have to have him on the Instagram someday.
You should.
As a legend of Chili's.
Now that we know where he lives and where he's from, you might as well.
I'd go hunt him down.
Bring him. How did this get to this point? He's alone. There's nobody else in the car.
Right. So yeah. That's, I usually go to Chili's alone. Maybe I'll have a companion.
Yeah.
I'll take him to a different one, though. Right? He's not welcome back at the Port Charlotte one for sure.
No. So anyway, that's the big story that we found on. It's funny that it's at Chili's. I don't know. At Chili's, you don't see that type of nonsense. You don't see that kind of.
Usually not.
Rough and rowdy.
Everybody's in a good mood when they're at Chili's.
Yeah, that's what I don't understand.
Maybe he was mad about a sports game or something.
So, all right. So we're going to move on to the next segment, Schubert. Time for the B rating. You ready for this?
Who's the reigning champion? That one looks good.
So, I've created a new rule for this. So, I'm going to drink. It's called Resilience Sound and Silence.
There's a buffalo on it. So
it's a buffalo. So, this is one of my favorite new breweries by far. I haven't had this one. This is actually out of Littleton, New Hampshire. It's not that far away. They've been incredible. So, they put out some good stuff. I've had a few of them. So, I'm going to try this, but I'm going to do like the bar stool style. One sip. Everybody knows the rules. I'm going to do it one time. I have never had this beer before. Give an initial rating and go from there. Let you know whether it's worth it or not worth it. And then we'll see if it compares to the BBC Wizard drink here. So, let's see what happens.
Have at it. Should I be sipping my Bud Light and doing the same thing?
All right, that is actually really, really good.
He likes it.
Let me try this one more time.
That's two sips.
It's got like an orange, I would say like a papaya almost taste to it. Probably they really narrow it down. Very fruity. Aftertaste is incredible. So this is a good one. This is a really good one. This is a double IPA. Let me see here.
Some high octane.
8.5%. Really good. Really good. All right. I'm going to score these. And also, if you follow us at the Drunken Nerds on Untappd or my Twitter, Drunken Saber, I'll put these on there as well to let you know what I think about these beers, what we're drinking. I'm going to have to give this like an 8.6.
Wow.
I don't want to put it too high. That's high.
That's setting the bar pretty high.
But I don't want to put it too high because I don't want to, like, you know, you I can't give it 10.0.
Back yourself into a corner.
Yeah, I can't back myself into a corner. That is actually really, really good. So that's from Resilience. I like that. I like that a lot.
So what everybody's been waiting for, does it beat the BBC? One more sip.
I'm going to give it to this one.
We have a new champion, people.
This is the new champion. Sound and Silence from Resilience. This is incredible. Yep, I highly recommend this. Can I tell you a story how I got this?
Go for it.
So last week, you remember, I had the beer. I think it was Aeronaut. And the beer before that.
Didn't go down too well.
No, it didn't go down that great. But I bought a whole, like, 25 beers from this liquor store. None of them tasted great. And one of the beers had, like, chunks all over the place. So, you know, I'm done. I'm done with the craft beer stores. So I went to my old faithful. It's this little hole-in-the-wall convenience store. You know, every week they get new craft beers in. So I go in there, and so I go, I'm looking for beers. And so my man, this guy who's, every time I go, this little Indian guy gets excited when I come in. So I'm looking at the beers. He goes, what are you looking for? I'm like, anything new this week? And so he showed me the new beers. And so he pulled this one out. He goes, I just got this in about 10 minutes ago. And it's like, oh, it's great, man. You know, you always have the best beers. And so I told him the story about last week about getting the beers, this craft beer. So he got all excited. He was all happy about it. But this guy really takes care of his beer. I feel like any beers that are supposed to be out of the cooler, it goes out of the cooler. Any beers that are supposed to be in the cooler, go in the cooler. So his name's Adhar or Adhar. But so I said, all right, I trust you.
Butchering that, but
I think how do you say it? Adhar. It's like Adhar.
I don't know the guy, so I don't know. Hopefully he's not listening.
He's listening. I'm telling you right now because I'm going to get to that. So we talk about it. So he goes, okay, I'll take it. And then I tell him about, you know what? We're doing a podcast tonight. I'm going to feature this beer because you recommended it. And he goes, what's the podcast? And I said, The Drunken Nerds. He goes, write it down. So I wrote down our name of the podcast on YouTube. He goes, I'm going to watch you guys tonight. And I go, I'll give a shout out. Atkinson Country Village Store.
Shout out.
In New Hampshire. This guy is the man. So I told him about, you know, going to this craft beer store where they have so much selection, where I feel like they don't even take care of any of the beers anymore. So they put them out. When you come home, they're just basically skunked. So he gave me all – he actually gave me this four-pack for free.
Good
man. He actually gave me a four-pack for free. I got a 12-pack of Bud Light as well.
Good man, too.
Yeah, got that one. He did charge me for the Bud Light, but did not charge me for the Resilience. So he sent me this text. So he was sitting there over the counter, and he goes, well, do you want my phone number in case you want anything? I go, I'll take your phone number. He goes, is there any beer that you want? Or, you know, if you want to see if anything's in stock, you know, send me a text. I said, okay, I'll take it. So I got all excited. So I left. And in my mind, I'm like, oh, my goodness. This is like when I was in high school, like when somebody gets a drug dealer and they're like all excited. Like, I have the hookup now.
You get the source.
So if somebody's like, I'm hanging out with you one time, like, oh, I really want to go for this beer. I'm like, well, let me talk to my dealer. I got a beer dealer now.
So if anybody has some suggestions for Dan, be sure to leave them in the comments or send them to us over on Twitter.
Yeah, because I think Adhar is going to hook you up. So I got my own personal beer dealer now. So you can grab anything if you feel like anything or Nova beer, he'll order it. So anyway.
8.2, you get some challengers coming at you.
Yeah, yeah. So, I don't know. This guy's incredible. I feel like some beer stores, you just can't get good beers. But this guy knows how to do it.
Perfect. But,
all right. Well, I think it's a new champion there. So, we come to the Schubert Trivia.
Yeah, we're gonna have a new champion this week in this segment as well.
You think so?
It's going to be me.
All right. We made it to Schubert Trivia. Stump the Schubert.
I'm going to
do a little better than last week.
Yeah, I had a poor showing, so we're going to see if I bounce back.
You kept blaming the questions.
And I'm going to continue this week, probably.
All right, so you know the deal. So if you get it right, I'll take a sip. Get it wrong, you take a sip. What do you think you're going to get out of six?
After last week's show, I'm hoping for four, but three is probably more realistic.
So you're cutting yourself low.
I am. We'll see what happens.
All right.
I didn't have a good showing, so I got to kind of game the system here. See. We'll see what happens.
All right. Are you ready?
Let's do it.
Okay, first question, Schubert. What was the first Happy Meal promotion McDonald's did?
First of all time, huh?
Yeah.
It's got to be Mickey Mouse.
That is incorrect. It is Star Trek.
Star Trek, wow.
Star Trek. And apparently they had like, they did like comic strips and also with a toy. So the only way you could actually finish the comic was to get all of them. So that's how it started, making sure you go to McDonald's constantly. And interesting. It worked. So
I didn't know that. And I've been watching a lot of, on the History Channel, The Food That Made America.
Yeah.
They didn't bring that up.
Yeah.
Watched one about Pizza Hut yesterday. They didn't bring it in. No Happy Meals yet, though.
Well, they screwed you. All right, you ready for your sip?
Yeah, I guess so.
I'm going to take one with you. This next one, I know you're not going to get based on your comment earlier.
A little earlier, who won the Puppy Bowl?
Yeah, but what was the name of the MVP in the Puppy Bowl?
I'm just going to throw out a dog name. Let's call her. I bet it wasn't a dog name, though. I bet it was like a human name. Felix.
No. The name was Marshall.
That's why I was close.
I guess so.
It was a human name, but like not a regular human name.
So you're 0-2. It was a Boston Terrier.
Good dog.
Yeah. Good. I think it was from Virginia.
Not from Boston.
He also won it. He was part of the Rough Squad. And they won. It's Rough versus Fluff. And he won it. So that's what
it wasn't like the Rough Riders versus the, what is that, Snoop's gang.
That would have been
cool.
It should have been. All right. You're up. You have a tough one next year.
See, this is why I still owe a sip, but this is why I guess hopefully three.
Yeah. This one I think you could definitely get.
All right.
Since you're a big fan. Name all seven.
Jesus, seven?
Of Billy Brown's children.
Oh, I'll get this.
Okay.
Can you do fingers for me, though?
I can do fingers.
I'm going to start from the top.
Okay.
Matt.
That's one.
Bam.
Two.
Gabe.
Three, yep.
Bear.
Yep, four.
Noah.
Yep.
Bird.
That's correct.
And Rain.
Yeah. Oh, there we go.
Yeah, here we go.
All right. Cheers to that.
All right. I don't know if I would have been able to do it without the counting them off. Thank you for that.
Gotcha. All right. You got one right. Last time, I don't think you got one right until the last one.
I don't think it was till five or six.
It's so all smooth sailing from here, too.
All right. So I'm ahead of the place.
What band is Keanu Reeves in?
What band?
What band is he playing?
Like not the Bill and Ted band, like his actual band?
His actual band. He's the bassist.
It's the Hollywood with Alice Cooper and Johnny Depp. That's not him, right?
No.
Something I know, or I'm never gonna get this. It's not the Wild
Stallions. I've never heard of them when I pulled it up, so.
All right, so I'll give my guess. The Wild Stallions.
No. It's the Dog Star.
Never in a million years.
Yeah. No, I had no idea. I had no idea he was in the band. Apparently he does it all, though.
Does he tour?
I don't know. That's a good question.
If he doesn't tour, then I don't think it counts.
Well, it's an active fan, though.
All right. We'll see.
So they said it's hard because All the attention goes to Keanu Reeves. So the band's in a little bit of hot water over there.
Well, that's why, what's his name from Stranger Things quit to his band? Steve.
Yeah, just too much. All the attention's on him.
Yeah.
So
they were good too.
Yeah.
Good with him, good before him, good after him.
But. Mm-hmm. All right, ready for question number five?
I've got to get the next two.
Yep. You're not going to get this. I don't think. Maybe you will.
You said it was smooth sailing.
Well, it's all in your wheelhouse. In what year did T-Rex Restaurant open in Disney World? Oh,
good Lord. I'm going down the – it wasn't there when it was Pleasure Island. Pleasure Island closed. Do I get a plus or minus one? I gotta get exact.
I think you have to get exact.
2004.
No. 2008. You owe me two sips now at this point.
I think I gotta go get a refresher.
You gotta get a refresher already?
I didn't expect to do this poorly.
You ready for the last one?
Give me 1 second.
All right, deal. So Schubert is usually pretty good at trivia. He is failing miserably this past 2 weeks, though. So let's hope he can at least get this last question done.
What's that?
So at least get you the last question here.
I better get it. The Stump the Shoe is becoming a boring segment because shit, you should go the other way. Will Shoe get one right?
It's true. Well, you got one so far. I think you can probably get this last one.
I hope so. We'll see if Ty can tie last week's score.
All right, you ready?
Throw it at me.
What is the name of Tom Brady's new boat?
Oh, is this real or?
Yes, this is what he was on the river with.
Had to be seven rings, right?
No.
Fuck.
Viva a Vida.
Viva a Vida. All right.
Viva a Vida.
I figured for sure it would be seven rings.
Yeah. Because, put it in front of Belichick's face.
Yeah, because the name of Belichick's boat is six rings.
Yeah.
But no, Tom's not as petty as the rest of us.
He's not as petty. Viva a Vida, apparently. 55 foot.
What does a Vida mean?
I have no idea. No clue.
It's got to mean something cool. Yeah.
Yeah. Apparently he's plastered all over the boat when he's doing his little parade today.
All right. So yeah. one for six.
You tied the same record as last week.
I thought I got two last week.
You only got one.
Yeah. So nowhere to go. Nowhere to go but up.
You have to go up next week. All right. I'll try to make them a little bit easier. I thought I had a couple that you could definitely get, but.
Which one did you think I would get?
The Happy Meal.
Really?
Yep. The Puppy Bowl. After what you said earlier, I figured maybe you watched the Puppy Bowl. And once you said that, I said he's no chance to get that one.
You thought I just would pull out of my ass what you're the. T-Rex opened.
You know how most restaurants have established.
I was reading the manifesto before.
A lot of time you spend at the beer, there had to be an established like plaque on there when they came out. But apparently not. All right, we'll go to the last segment. Apparently we have no like photos of me and you. So I found that one a long time ago at the T-Rex bar. That's when we first went to the T-Rex bar, actually.
That was the night that lives in infamy, which is a story for a different time.
Yeah, a different time. But that was the beginning of the T-Rex bar, how we found out it was so amazing that we go every single time we go there.
It's why everybody there knows my name right now.
That's true. So let's talk about what's up for the weekend. So, Schubert, what's going on over there?
Yeah, as I said earlier, I booked a place on property at Universal. So, I'll be spending Saturday, Sunday there. We got a long weekend Monday.
So, you're spending Sunday, Valentine's Day by yourself?
Oh, I forgot about that. Yes, yes. We'll see. maybe Saturday at Universal, we'll find a Harry Potter fan that would like some company.
Yep. It's still a good weekend.
I'm going to go buy my magic wand and do that. The magic wand at Harry Potter World is pretty cool. I'm going to go buy one and see if I can do a girlfriend spell.
Smart idea. Hey, I'm still down if I can sneak out of here and be back like first thing Sunday morning and be like, hey, I didn't leave. I didn't forget about Valentine's Day. Then maybe.
Yeah, you can do a pretty quick flight. Just pop down, go to sleep, pop back. You're back in 36 hours.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea.
So, just say you're going out for like milk or something.
Right. Yeah.
But yeah, I'm going to go hard both days. We said it last time that maybe we'd hop on Instagram Live at Around the World.
Yeah.
I'm going to say it. We'll try again this weekend.
Yeah, we should.
I'll try to hop on.
Started. I know that we're getting a little rough. We're trying to add some new segments. But we're going to start getting better with social media and everything, hang in there with everybody. But we're getting there. We're getting there.
Yeah, so I'll probably from Harry Potter world, I'll hop on Instagram Live, see what I'm getting into.
Yeah, I like it. So obviously, I'm stuck doing Valentine's Day. It's going to be horrible. I'm not going to spend, like $75 on a dozen roses that usually cost like $10.
Now, does Valentine's Day always fall on the day before President's Day where you have a day off the next day too?
It never happens this way.
I feel like it's just like rubbing salt in the wound. We're like,
yeah,
you have a night where you begin it like blackout drunk and not have to work the next day. Nope, you got to spend it with your lady.
Yeah, no, it's going to suck. And especially like, I don't know. It's not going to be fun. They expect kids. It's like basically like another birthday for the woman. They get two birthdays a year, Valentine's Day and their birthday. So
we also, I believe we have a NXT pay-per-view
Valentine's Day night. We do have NXT pay-per-view and we have the UFC.
Yeah. We have Burns Usman on Saturday. So that'll be good.
So WWE knows what they're doing. They put the NXT takeover on Valentine's Day. It's just like something to get excited for anybody who's single.
I'm one of these people, but I think that I'm their target audience.
Yeah.
NXT's target audience is people like me.
Yeah. Well, I'd rather be you come Sunday. I'll tell you that much. So, but yeah, that's on track for the weekend for myself.
Yeah. What are you doing? Are you good with, besides trying to sneak down?
Trying to sneak down. I've basically been staying up till 8 to 9 o'clock in the morning watching the Australian Open, and that's probably going to continue all the way until Sunday. So
you're probably going to get another snowstorm, right? So I heard you had a snowblower incident.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. The other day we had another 4 inches, and I ran over my dog's run, ripped it apart. So I'm screwing the snowblower up left and right. It's not good. It sucks up here. I do need to get down there to Florida. I don't know what I'm doing up here in New Hampshire. So
you're missing out on some souvenir cups.
I need to find some. There's no souvenir cups around here. Not good.
You got an over-under for me for Saturday?
For what?
Souvenir cups.
I'm going to say, well, you say you're not going to go to City Walk.
I'm going to try to.
For you?
I'm definitely going to Margaritaville.
So there's one.
There's one. Yeah.
I want you to get at least three.
I think three is a fair number.
Can you get three?
Yeah.
All right. Three souvenir cups. That's perfect. So. All right.
All right. Until next week.
Until next week.
You can remember to follow us.
Cheers.
At the Drunken Nerds. Instagram. Twitter. The Works. I'm at Matt Does It All on The Works. Twitch. Insta. Twitter. Dan,
you're going to be at
the Drunken Saber.
Yep. Drunken Saber on Twitter. And we're going to be more active. You know, that we're still trying to get that, get it going here. We're going to be more active on social media. So follow this and that, and we'll get going here. We'll see. But we're going to be doing this every week. We're doing this every week.
On the ground floor. The ground floor.
That's right. The ground floor. I know we're going to, I feel like every Wednesday, Thursday, we'll put out a podcast. And we'll get better every week.
Yeah. Until next week.
Until next week. And thank you, Ahmad.
Have a beer on us.
I know you're watching, buddy. All right. I'll see you later.
Enjoy your beers.
Cheers.